This video is going to be five things to say. Oh, do I need the mic on? Oh, it's on. Oh my God. Okay, let's start again. Today we're gonna talk about five things not to say to someone who is pregnant. Number one, oh my God, you're huge. As we all know, if you're new here, hi, I'm really pregnant and I'm really showing and I have a really big belly. I happen to be a very petite girl. My belly is large. Maybe I'm carrying a very large baby. Maybe she's super healthy, which would be a great thing, but it really doesn't make you feel good when every 5 seconds someone's telling you how huge you are. I have already gained 40 pounds in this pregnancy. I'm embracing it. It's the first time in my life where I've actually like been okay with it. It's hard to see your body change when you're getting ready to go somewhere and nothing fits, or you look like a giant house and you don't feel your best. And the first thing someone says is, oh my God, you're huge, doesn't really make you feel good. Lately, I've been posting photos on Instagram and everybody's been saying, oh my God, you look like you're about to pop. What are you, having twins in there? Oh my God, I'm having round ligament pain right now. Hold on, I was sitting in the wrong position and it's like Charlie horsing in my stomach, hold on. Okay, let's breathe through it. Anyway, I'm gonna calm down. Okay, I'm back. Telling someone they look like they're about to pop when they still have a good amount of time left in the pregnancy, what it does for me is it has instilled so much fear. I'm terrified of having this baby early. I want this baby to go to term. So it's made me very unsure and scared. So that would be the first thing that I would say. Maybe don't say how huge someone is when they're pregnant. Maybe say you look beautiful and wow, your baby's gonna be really healthy. Just tell me I look pretty. That's all I wanna hear. Or that everything's gonna be okay. Number two, unsolicited diet advice. Many of us who are pregnant know what we should be eating and what we shouldn't be eating. I can't tell you how many people have said, is that sugar that you're eating? You should lay off because you might get gestational diabetes. If I was at risk for gestational diabetes, I would not be eating sugar. I have a doctor who monitors all this stuff and I know what I am able to eat and not able to eat. So if I'm craving the damn cookie or the sugar or the watermelon or whatever it is that I want to eat, I'm going to eat it responsibly. There's never been a time in my life where I could sit and eat a pint of ice cream and not feel guilty about it. The only thing I feel guilty about is that I want my baby eating only healthy things, so I make sure it's organic. All you pregnant mamas out there, eat the damn ice cream. Number three, please stop telling first-time pregnant parents that their life is about to end. One, I don't believe that. I think your life gets significantly better. And everybody says it's the best thing and the hardest thing you'll ever do in your life. And I'd like to be positive and think it's gonna just be the best thing. When people say get used to not sleeping, I don't know what planet you're living on, but clearly you've never been pregnant before because I'm not sleeping now. The bigger I get, the harder it is to sleep. It just gets so uncomfortable and you can't breathe and you're lying in weird positions and your body hurts, your hips hurt and your spine is in a weird position. You can't lay on your back because the baby would not get enough oxygen and you have to lay on your left side, but what if you want to lay on your right side? And what if you're a stomach sleeper? And there's just so many things you have to think about. Number four, please, for the love of God, stop telling first-time pregnant women your horror stories. Pregnancy is hard enough. We have enough anxiety and stress as it is about making sure that we're doing everything right. Getting the pregnancy to stick in the first trimester, then worrying about getting the right nutrition, worrying about the right amount of exercise, taking care of our bodies, making sure that we're doing everything we possibly can for the health of this child and for ourselves. To add more stuff that could potentially go wrong is the worst thing you could possibly say to someone who is pregnant for the first time. I feel like the next one, I've been through it and I get it, and it won't matter what people say to me because I'll know my experience. But because I've never experienced this before, hearing these things just brings so much fear that I don't want that to happen to me. Don't tell me your horror birth stories. It should just be beautiful. And if you want to share stories, share beautiful ones with pregnant women because our hormones are also kind of crazy, as you could probably tell by me needing to do this video. Number five. That's it. I love you guys. I don't mean for this video to be at all a lecture or at all that I'm irritated. I love the support of this community. I love my online family and all of the fans and followers. and my family and friends that are in my life. It's just a little bit of advice firsthand on someone who's really pregnant and really hormonal. At the end of the day, you don't know what anyone's really going through. I've learned that through my pregnancy journey, trying to get pregnant, getting pregnant, and this entire journey, is you really don't know what someone's going through, and you don't know what question can trigger a really, really big fear, insecurity, or vulnerability in someone. And that's it. Love you guys. Thanks for watching. My rant. I'll see you next week.